Hello students, welcome to the company law and administration subject. So in the previous class we have seen about the independent directors and as well as the CFO, that is a chief financial officer. Coming to the next important key managerial personnel, that is company secretary. So your company secretary is one of the most important member relating to the company. So the word secretary is derived from the Latin word secretarius, which means the confidential officer. That is, he is a person who is very near to the company. His work will start right from the formation of the company and his work will end till the company is closed. So he is a person who will do the routine work such as office administration, writing the legal letters, reports, proceedings, minutes of meeting, etc. He is a person who is compiled with the Companies Act, or he is a person who is well versed with the Companies Act, Security Exchange Board of India, Foreign Exchange Management, Income Tax Department and other economic law. So he is a person who will act as a link between the director shareholders. So under the Companies Act 2013, a company secretary is included in a key managerial person, that is KMP. So he is a person who is very important for the company. So here Companies Act 1956 defines the company secretary as a person. A company secretary is a person who is a member of Institute of Company Secretary of India or any other individual possessing the prescribed qualification appointed to perform duties imposed on him by the Companies Act, the ministerial or administrative duties and managerial function that are delegated by him by the board, right? So as you all know that company secretary, that is CS, is now it is a course which everyone is pursuing along with their BCom. It is just like your chartered accountant and ICWAI. Company secretary is even the qualification which a person needs to possess to be a company secretary of a particular company. So he is a person who will be looking out the legal matters as a chartered accountant who will be looking after all the accounting or the financial matters of the company. In the same way, a company secretary is a person who will be looking into the legal matters of the company. So here he has to qualify that his qualification will be company secretary from the company secretary of the India or the prescribed qualification which is laid by the Companies Act. So he is a person who will be administrating and managing the functions which are given by the board. Then coming to the features of according to this definition, what it says, only an individual can be appointed as a company secretary. Like the whole firm or the institution is not called as a company secretary, so only the one person here. And he should have the qualification which is prescribed by the Institute of Company Secretaries in India. Then his duties of the company secretary are ministerial and administrative. That is, his duty is at a higher level here. Okay, and his name is covered under the key managerial person under the Companies Act. And the company secretary is a whole-time key managerial person here. Then the appointment of the company secretary to the company is compulsory here, that is mandatory here. So here under section 188 says that if it is a public company which has more than three directors and one of them is qualified, then that director is appointed as a secretary by obtaining the consent of the company by passing a special resolution here. Okay, so that was a analysis of the definition, wherein we have seen the qualification and an individual can be appointed as a company secretary. Coming to the appointment of the company secretary, so a section 203 of Companies Act provide the compulsory appointment of the whole time key personnel, that is here nothing but a company secretary, as prescribed by the central government. So here the first here is from the promoter, like first the promoter of the company will appoint the secretary who will help them from the formation of the company, that is right from the paper, that is starting with the legal paper. He will be the person who will be helping in arranging all the documents and whatever the legal procedure are there, he will be helping to the for the promoter. Here he need to prepare the documents and statements which are required for the registration of the company, then arranging the meeting for the promoter, preparing the minutes. Here minutes means what? Here whatever discussion are taken in the meeting are written down here. So he is referred here as a pro tem secretary, that is temporary secretary, and his name is included in the articles of the company. Why here he is called as a temporary secretary? Because he is appointed before the incorporation, that is during the promotion stage he is appointed, so he will be named here as a temporary secretary. Then a regular secretary, that is he is appointed as a key managerial person. So a secretary is one of the managerial person. So here every company should have a whole time company secretary. Then here he shall be holding office for like less than 1 year. One company, that is a whole time key managerial shall not hold the office in one more than one company except in the subsidiary at the same time. That is only one secretary will be there for one company. Then these company secretary will be appointed by the board of director at the certain remuneration will be given. Okay, so that will be decided by the company's board members of the company by passing the special resolutions. Then now, which company should appoint a whole-time company secretary? Which company should? So if yours is a private company and the share capital of the private company is more than 5 crores, then it should have a company secretary. Then the public with a share capital of more than 5 crores and less than 10 crores, and the public company with a share capital more than 10 crores must appoint him as a company secretary. So under these three conditions, wherein the turnover is more than 5 crores, then that company must compulsorily have the full-time company secretary. Then now what is a procedure for the appointment? So the procedure is, first here is as usual resolution in the board meeting, that is first you have to pass the board meeting. Then in that they should specify the terms and conditions for the appointment. They should cross verify the qualification, then they should fix the remuneration, then the membership member will be allotted to them. Then next, consent to act as a company secretary. That is, consent is like, it is like a permission or asking the opinion from the company secretary to act. That is to like whoever is qualified here, they will be asked his consent whether they are willing to work here as a company secretary with the prescribed rules and regulation, terms and conditions, and with that particular remuneration, are they ready to work as a company secretary. Then next year, after that, communicating it to the registrar of the company, right? We already know who is this registrar of the company, who will be situated where the location of the company is there. That is a registrar of a state. They have to fill this form of MGT, okay, for the consent of the that is a consent letter. And the copy of the board resolution, that is a board meeting which is passed, that is within 30 days of the board meeting, they have to pass this. Then next is company required to fill one more form, that is MR1 at the time of appointment. Within 60 days of this board resolution, that is within 2 months, then the same documents are to be attached here. Then there is one more, DRI-12. There is a need to file the form of DIR for the appointment of the secretary as a key member person, as here KM, that is key managerial personnel, within the 30 days of passing the board resolution with the consent letter, appointment letter and self-attested copy of PAN card and copy of the board resolution. So these are the certain important documents before appointment, they have to be submitted here in the prescribed form. Then after that, who will be not qualified, or who will be the person, like under what criteria person is not appointed as a company secretary in case of the public limited company? So here a director of the company, if there is only a two director in a public company, so if the company is having only two director, then out of that one, if the company is having only two director, for such company the company secretary is not appointed, and already who is the auditor of the company is not appointed as a company secretary. And any person who is not eligible, maybe because of many reasons, right? We have already seen the reason, if he is imprisoned and if he is insolvent, then such person is not qualified, then without possessing required qualification, right? So we have already seen the qualification, that is, he need a company secretary qualification, then only he will be eligible for the company secretary post. Then next coming to the qualification, right? We have seen qualification, but let us see them in the detail. So public company with a paid up share capital of 10 crores or more should appoint its whole time secretary to perform the duties. Any individual possessing the membership of ICSI, that is Institute of Company Secretary India, from that institution who has completed the CS shall be appointed as a company secretary. Then in case of the companies with a paid up share capital less than 10 crores, any individual possessing any qualification may be appointed as a whole time secretary to perform the duties. So in case of paid up capital less than 10 crores, then the membership of ICSI, then or who has passed the intermediate examination, or who is a postgraduate in the commerce or the corporate secretary avoided by any university, they shall be appointed if the paid up capital is less. If the paid up capital is more than 10 crores, then they have to compulsorily appoint a company secretary. If the company's paid up capital is less, then if the person is possessing these following qualification can be appointed here as a company secretary. Then degree in the law, which is avoided by the university, that is LLB. Then he can have a qualification of ICWAI, that is Institute of Cost and Work Accountant. Then CA, then postgraduate, that is PG in law and secretarial practice, which is granted by the Udaipur University. Then member of Association of Secretaries and Manager from Calcutta. Then if he has a qualification of Diploma in Corporate Law and Management granted by the Indian Law Institute of New Delhi. Then postgraduate degree or diploma in Management Science granted by any of the university. Then postgraduate degree or diploma granted by the Indian Institute of Management, Bengaluru, Calcutta, Lucknow, Ahmedabad or Calicut. So in case if he is not qualified for a company secretary, then out of these 11 qualification, if the person is having any one of the qualification, will be appointed as a company secretary, but only to the public company which is having the paid up capital less than 10 crores. Then coming to the qualities what the company secretary should have, we have seen the qualification, but along with the qualification, a person need additionally, he need a qualities. The first one is sound general education, that is, he should have the basic knowledge of grasping out or taking out or the analyzing the subject matter. Then command over the language, that is fluency, that is whenever the company secretary is asked to prepare one report, he should be at least able to prepare that report. So it is necessary that he should have at least a good communication skill here. Then if he need to communicate with the foreign companies, then he should be able to do that. So if he is well versed with some foreign language, then it is a well and good. Then next is knowledge of office administration. This is very important. Okay, so in which company he is working as a company secretary, then he should be knowing the system of that office, that is how legally the work will be taken there. Then he should have the knowledge about the labors, then recruitment, then staff members and method of remuneration, then how to take the work. Overall administration work he should be well versed with that. Then accounting and taxation. This accounting and taxation with company law, these two knowledge are very important. Because these are the two concepts wherein accounting and taxation and the law on which the company or any business will be functioning. So he should have the thorough knowledge when he is working into that. Any mistake or any negligence from his side will definitely cause a huge loss to the company here. Then coming to the he should have a knowledge of various act relating to the staff. That is, we know that there are Labor Welfare Act, Provident Fund Act in case of the wages, Factory Act we have, Industrial Dispute Act we have, Women Compensation Act we have, right, and Income Tax Act we have. These all act are related to the company which will be correspondingly functioning. That is, these are the law on which the company is standing. So he should be knowing it in a detail so that he could benefit it to the employees. Okay, so that is time to time the wages should be paid here, and time to time the provident fund have to be paid here. Then in case of any disputes here, he has to apply which act that must be that knowledge he must be possessing. Then next is knowledge of mercantile law. That is, apart from the knowledge of law which is relating to the staff, a working knowledge of the law also, that is negotiable instrument, sale of goods act and insurance act, he must be well versed with that act also. Then knowledge of industry, that is you can say that the knowledge of industry wherein your company is engaging, right? So like the company is working in the society, that is a hub of industry, wherein he should have the knowledge of all these industry, how they are functioning. Then the general knowledge, which is very important. Then he should have the common sense and the general knowledge, which will help the company and the company secretary himself to be updated here. So it will help the secretary in guiding the chairman, it will help in guiding the board of director, and it will help him to perform his duty very confidently. So in the he should be well versed what is the current situation which is going on. So for that, possessing the general knowledge is very necessary. Then next, he should have an impressive personality. So along with the qualification, he should have a very good convincing capacity, so that whatever he wants to communicate, he should communicate that clearly with the board member. So here the qualification mentioned above are along with that, he should be successful to execute that. So he must have the good personality. Then he should have a good personality here. Then organizing ability, imaginative, initiative, and strong common sense and intelligence. And along with that, he should be a responsible person also. So this was about the qualification, and that is along with the qualities of the company secretary. It was a short introduction to who is company secretary and what is his qualification. So in the next class, we will be seeing with his duties.